Okay.
Whenever you're ready, Jen.
Hello, my name is Tom Martin, this is my senior project assistant, and also my steam captain. My essential question is, what are the steps required to create a successful technology website teaching tool based on different levels of understanding? My outline, before we get into the presentation, this is outline of what we cover, why I chose this project, what is my project, timeline, or reflection of what didn't work, why we need more time, and was it successful, link to my website, and then acknowledgements. So why I chose this project, the reason I chose this project is to help people learn more about digital technology, no matter where they currently stand on their understanding of the topics. I'm wanting to learn more about computers that one starts at different places, so, and jumping in at first can be kind of overwhelming. To solve this issue, I'm going to create a quiz to sort people based on what they're in, so they can start off where they can be. So what I hope to accomplish is to help people get into computers in a more manageable way. There's enough information in the summaries to establish a great baseline knowledge and easily navigate the current CPU and GPU markets. The project is meant to act as sort of jumping off point or catalyst for people who learn about computers. So what you need to know is I created a quiz to sort people based on the level of understanding of various computer components using a Google form and added into the website. The website was created using a creation tool called Squarespace. And it is a subscription-based tool that costs $27 a month before you have paid out of pocket. And the website covers two topics, CPUs and GPUs. The summary is broken down into three levels for a total of six summaries. The summaries get progressively more advanced and cover some different aspects of components. The project is only meant to give you a good general knowledge of the topics, not teach you the complete inner workings of the technology. So my timeline, the creation of the website was from December 2020 to January 2021. My research went from November to March 2021, and then the creation and testing of the quiz was from February of 2021 to March of 2021. One test was in February and one was in March. The testing was among the STEAM advisor students, and feedback from the testing the quiz was very positive. After the first test, I had the third option to many of the questions on the test. The option was an I don't know option for people who didn't know and it helped to keep the results more accurate, helped to stop people from just guessing if they didn't know the answer. The feedback from the second testing session with the STEAM class was that I needed to show the users what level they'd be placed into based on their final score, and I added that feature on the header of the Google form, which you see as we get to the website. Polishing the website happened in May, and then the CPU and GPU summaries happened in March. So why I chose to do the project the way I did. So I chose to only do two topics, three summaries each because of time constraints. And I wanted to include a lot of information in your summary. And the best way to do this was to cut down on the number of topics to make sure the project was manageable. So I chose to use a website creation tool, like I talked about earlier, Squarespace, instead of making a website from scratch, because the project was more focused on content on the website rather than the creation of the website itself. And then I used a Google form to create the quiz because it is a free and easy tool that can easily be integrated into the website. It also allows the quiz to be quickly graded and give me feedback on what people are getting it right or wrong. So what didn't work? My plan to have all the summaries teach the same material, but at higher difficulty levels didn't work. I decided that it was best to cover different aspects of components at different levels so that users who wanted to read all three summaries can get more out of those summaries instead of just reading the same summary over and over again, but slightly more difficult. And I decided it was best to talk about more advanced topics as the summaries progress rather than the same ones at different levels. And it makes it so that my website has more useful information. As I mentioned earlier, my original plan is to have more than two topics covered, but I quickly realized that if I wanted to give as much attention to each topic as I wanted, I was going to have to do fewer topics. I was also planning to create a build it yourself section to coincide with newly acquired knowledge, but the section never came to fruition, and I'll explain why later. So what do I wish I had time to do differently? I wish that I had more time to complete the full list of summaries. As you can see in the pictures, system memory and SSD and hard drive memories, they didn't get completed, and also that is the build it yourself section. It's under construction because I couldn't get to that. So I couldn't get all the components necessary for the build-it-yourself section. SSD hard drive summaries, and also add the monitor summaries that I was planning on. And I would then improve the placement quiz by grouping the questions into categories for a more customized experience. Because as of now, if you know a lot about, say, CPUs, but not a lot about anything else, like computer memory or monitors and GPUs, then you may get recommended for a lower level across the board, even if you can handle CPU level 2 or 3, which is an issue. So, and if I had an additional year, I would complete the Build It Yourself section and possibly add a current events tab to give people an easy place to learn about new technology that is in the news and being talked about. And this section would be a really interesting addition to my project that would give people a reason to keep coming back. This is the link to my website. You can scan the QR code.
What do you hope to do with this website, or what would you hope to see